Hi, I'm Jonathan Wild, and we are going to cover how to compute cash flows from financing activities. Financing activities involve long-term liability and equity items, which includes cash received from issuing debt and cash repayment of those amounts borrowed. It also includes cash received or distributed to owners. However, it does not include cash lent or collected for notes receivable. These are investing activities, which is covered in another video. Now, to identify financing activities, we review our financial statements and some additional information from the accounting system, like what is shown here. For financing activities, we focus on the long-term liabilities and equity section of the balance sheet. First, we see that notes payable increased by $12,000. To find out what happened, we look at our additional information and see that the company acquired $12,000 of land by issuing $12,000 of notes payable. Because no cash was ever exchanged, but this still is a significant investing and financing activity, we report it as a separate schedule to the statement of cash flows. Under non-cash investing and financing activity, we report that the company acquired land with issuance of notes for $12,000. Next, we see that bonds payable decreased by $6,800. So we look at our additional information and see that the company retired bonds payable with a $6,800 book value before maturity by paying $3,600 cash, which created a $3,200 gain. And the journal entry would look something like this. So as you can see, the $6,800 decrease in bonds payable is explained by the retirement before maturity. Now for the cash flow effect, we see that the company paid $3,600 to retire the bonds. Therefore, we report $3,600 cash paid to retire the bonds payable under financing activities. Back to our balance sheet. We now move on to the equity section and see that common stock increased by $3,000. So, looking at our additional information, we see that the company issued 3,000 shares of $1 par value common stock for $3,000. And the journal entry would look something like this. As you can see, the company received $3,000 in cash from the sale of stock. We would report this inflow as cash received from issuing stock under financing activities. Now, looking back at our equity section, we see that retained earnings increased by $4,800. If you remember, retained earnings is increased by net income and decreased by dividends. Looking at our income statement, we see net income is $7,600. And looking at our additional information, we see that the company distributed $2,800 of cash dividends. The $7,600 of net income is already accounted for in the operating section, but the $2,800 needs to be reported. Therefore, we record cash paid for dividends of $2,800 under financing activities. So to wrap it up, the cash flows from financing activities section of our statement of cash flows will look something like this. In total, we report net cash used in financing activities of $3,400. The negative number, or parentheses around the number, tell us that we had more outflows of cash than inflows. This is why we report net cash used in financing activities, whereas if we had a positive cash flow, we would say net cash provided by financing activities.